My trends are gone. What is this
name? Oh, oh. Tonight's not going to be 35 years.
Couple of new faces here that don't know this story. But while I was doing my main work that I did when I was young and in middle life, the boss came to us one day and he said, "Boys, we're going to do this Christmas song and I want one of you trumpet players to do something on it that I heard them do the other day on TV." Can you imagine who this man is I'm talking about?
My Uncle Dave. From North Dakota.
Yeah. Oh.
It sounds just like
you know, I understand in North Dakota there's no off-ramps from the freeways. That's what they told us. And there was, right in front of Mr. Welk's house. So he brought all the four trumpet players into the office, and he brought out this song called Sleigh Ride. And he says, "Boys, I want to hear you play the trumpet, what do we call it, Nancy?
A Whinney song."
That's right, the Whinney song. You want the Whinney of the trumpet, you know, of the reindeer.
Right.
So he tried us all out, and he picked me. I was so happy. I loved to do that. I used to do it as a kid. You know, the Whinney of the reindeer. So we did the show. Came up there. It is. That's it. We did it, and the next year, same thing. He brought us all in there. He says, "Boys, we're going to do this again. I want to pick a trumpet player who can do it." He picked me again. I was so happy, but I was getting a little suspicious. I said, "Mr. Welk, you always pick me to do that. I mean, I said, I love to do it. I love to sing, to play it and on the show and everything, but you always pick me. Why is that?" He says, "Chani, you're the only one that doesn't charge me double."
That?
I have a clip up the top.
You sure do.
So
I forgot
you
it.
Just clip it.
It's right there.
There you go.
Oh, thank you very much. Evan. How about a hand for Laura?
Yay, Laura!
Everybody knows Laura. What a help she is. What a help.
Thank you.
Laura found this, family, for the end of our sermon today. It was just a wonderful writing. Luke 1, 1 through 4 really helps us see what Jesus was doing. It's kind of a picture of Luke giving us the exact evidence on Jesus. Everyone expects a toddler to be wobbly on their feet. But if they still wobble in the same way as a teenager, there's a problem. The same principle is true in the Christian life. It's no wonder new believers sometimes wobble. The problem is that too many of us remain stuck in the half-light of our early impressions of Jesus. We go on wobbling for years. Very human, huh? Luke wrote his account of Jesus' life to give a new believer, a man's name was Theophilus, so he's probably Greek, gave him stability in his faith. It's true, stability doesn't sound very exciting, but actually there's no greater treasure than a settled and clear certainty about Jesus and his kingdom. How did Luke intend to give Theophilus this stability? It's vital we all know the answer because God uses the same strategy today. Yes, throughout all of our problems, we can find stability. First, Luke intended to give an accurate account of the events. There's no stability if we're not certain that the events in Jesus' life, his birth, death, and resurrection, really happened. Luke had conducted careful research going back to the earliest eyewitnesses. He was a doctor, by the way, Dr. Luke. As we read his account, we can be confident that we have the facts. Second, he intended to give a full understanding of these events and their significance. In verse 1, Luke hints that their meaning had been explained long before they took place. Jesus fulfilled God's promises to Israel. Luke will show how that happened in his own orderly account. It's in verse 3. Orderly, not just because he writes the events down in the right order, but because they make sense in the light of God's promises. There's no time of the year when it's easier to get off balance than in the manic pre-Christmas buildup. We tend to shop, party, and worry like everyone else. It's possible to fall flat on our faces, spiritually that is, like the wobbling toddler. Let Luke's accurate, ordered account of Jesus' birth guide you into this Advent. I hope it helps you towards a faith that's increasingly stable and clear. I hope it does. That's our prayer for you, family. And let's pray this prayer and ask God to help us with this. Heavenly Father, in the busiest month of the year, give us the settled stability that comes from seeing Jesus accurately, fully, clearly, and coherently. We order our muddled minds and capture our distracted hearts. Do that, Father. We pray for that. Settle our lives on a vision of Jesus that is in keeping with his true glory. And we pray this all in his name, in Jesus' name. Have a wonderful Christmas week, family. We'll see you next week. God bless you.